Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. What do I start with? I think if this exam is so simple and so easy, and you listen to Raj Nandini's initial introduction, you would have solved two questions in general studies. Now, one question is, what's the role of UPSC? And another is, what's the history of civil services in India? So, there are a few things which I would want to talk about. I would start with a little bit, continuing from where Dr. Khan left. There's a very beautiful book by Nassim Nicholas Taleb. The book, name of the book is Antifragility, The Things Which Gain from Disorder. How many of you know the word fragile? Okay, what does fragile mean? Which is so delicate that whenever it encounters any pressure, whenever it encounters anything strong, any disorder, it disintegrates, it falls. And there's another word called resilient. What does resilient mean? Resilient means which can withstand that disorder. So the author introduces this word antifragile. Antifragile means those they don't disintegrate because of disorder. They not only withstand it but also become stronger. So a classic example of it is Hydra. We have heard about the story Hydra, right? You cut its one head to spring out of it. So that's an example of antifragile. So the whole point of telling this to you is, I think whenever a person starts to, you know, imagining himself, he wants to do something good, he needs to have this attitude. He needs to bring this quality of anti-fragility in himself or herself. Because come what may, whatever you want to do, whatever person wants to do, he'll face obstacles, he'll face problems, he'll face challenges. But the question there is whether those challenges make you fall back, or as Hansa pointed out, whether those challenges make you fall forward and you raise stronger and 5 inches ahead of where you had fallen from. I'll tell you one more example. We have a batchmate, his name is Ajay. Ajay is 100% blind. He's a batchmate, he's right now in Punjab Kada. Last year, during our last phase of training, we had gone for a foreign study tour. We went to London. So he and I were in the same group. So as it happened that those who had planned our tour, they had kept one meeting of us in a place called Policy Lab. It's in Whitehall. It's a UK body just like Niti Aayog we have here. So what they do in the Policy Lab is they sort of discuss and brainstorm and come up with ideas. And so it was, we were expecting that this would be a great experience. But when we went to that place, it was a simple, plain conference room. There was one lady, she had a PowerPoint presentation, and she kept on pressing the buttons for almost half an hour. And we were 18 of us, and we hardly could gather anything from what she was saying. So that half an hour was completely sort of waste for us. So then we were coming out of that building. It's located in the Her Majesty's Treasury building. So while we were coming out, Ajay is with me, and so he's holding my hand, and we're together coming out. And these are his words. Athar yaar, inhone hamara pura ek ghanta waste kar liya. Ye yahan kyun leke aaye hame? इनको तो हमें यहाँ के स्कूल दिखाने चाहिए, इनको तो हमें यहाँ के अस्पताल दिखाने चाहिए, हमें तो वापस जाके अस्पताल बनाने हैं, हमें वापस जाके बहुत अच्छे स्कूल बनाने हैं, बहुत अच्छे स्टेडियम बनाने हैं. So there's a person, he cannot see the school, there's a person, he cannot see that hospital, but he has that passion in himself that I want to see the school, I want to go back and make a better school for the people back in my country. So that's the zeal, that is the passion, that come what may, whatever challenges you have, you will emerge stronger, you will not let yourself down. So, what's the bottom line here? Now how do we reach to this sort of character? How do we build this sort of attitude in ourselves? I think the first and foremost thing is, a person, as Thansar also pointed out, one needs to have clarity in mind about what he wants to do. Not only that, he also needs to know why you want to do that. So I believe these are three important things for any examination, for any endeavor. Whether you want to start your company, these three things you need to know. First is what. What is it that you want to do? Are you starting the company? What company? Number second is why. Why do you want to do that? You want to join civil services? Why is it? You want to become a teacher? Why do you want to become a teacher? You want to become a professor? Why do you want to become a professor? You want to become a reporter? Why do you want to do that? You want to become a scholar? You want to do research? Why do you want to do that? That's the second part. And then comes the third part. That's the how part. Now if you're convinced about why you want to do it and you know what you want to do, then comes the third part. That's how you want to do. That's when a person seeks guidance, when a person seeks coaching. But I believe the first two parts are absolutely important. So as far as civil service examination is concerned, so the what part, so what is civil services about? I wish, and I, those of you who want to join, you spend some time knowing it. You spend some time knowing what is the role of an IAS officer. What is the role of an Indian Foreign Service officer? What does an IPS officer do? What is the role of an IRS officer? Many of us start preparing with just one word in mind, IAS, when it happens that out of those who are selected, mostly around 80% of them get services other than IAS. What is the role of those services? One needs to know that. Second part, of course, why? Why? That is, that's been always extremely important to me and will always stay that important to me. I'll tell you a few more examples about it. When we joined services, the civil service, we went to the academy. After that, we went to the state, met some of the senior officers. Trust me, almost half of them who have spent almost 20 years of service, some of 30 years of service, you talk to them, there's so much cynicism. So much of, yaar, pata nahi kyun join kiya, I could have done this, I could have done that. But at the same time, we also have seen people who retired, who have spent 35 years in service, and at the time of retirement, they say, if I get another life, I will do the same thing again. So, it's not, what I'm saying is this why is not just important enough to clear the examination. It's a motivation for what is there on the other side of this exam. Is this, if somebody has a fascination for money, for wealth, this certainly is not. We don't have that. We probably would be getting way less salary than anybody else gets in the private market. But is that it? For me, because I can share my own idea of it. Civil service is what it means, what it meant, what it's turning out to be. I give this example very often. How many of you are chemistry students? Ever read chemistry in your college or school? Okay. And what's a catalyst? Wonderful. That's experience of reaction. So I see the role of a civil servant is very similar to that of a catalyst. So what does it mean? Say you're not a doctor. Okay, so doctor is a main agent. But you can ensure that there's right kind of atmosphere, right kind of facilities for people, and they have good medical facilities. You're not yourself a teacher, but you have that opportunity, you have that ability, you have that authority that you can ensure that people get good education. You don't drive buses, but you can ensure that people have good mode of communication. So this role as a catalyst is something which fascinates me, which motivates me to join civil services. I am an SDM in a place called Badnor in Bhilwara, Rajasthan. So, sometimes say on one Monday morning, I started at 9 o'clock went to visit three schools in my subdivision. And by the time it's 11, all the other schools get to know that SDM is going and visiting schools. For almost next 1 month, there is no teacher absenteeism in that school, in those schools. You go and visit the hospital once in a month. For the entire next 1 month, doctors are there on time, paramedics are there on time, medicine availability is ensured, because they know probably there might be another visit coming soon. So this is something which I have found extremely amazing and extremely wonderful. And we often talk about passion, that one should find that passion. But many of us don't know what our passion is, right? And apna passion dhoondo, but hume pata nahi hota hamara passion kya hai. Usko dhoondne ke liye insaan ko thoda sa struggle karna bahut zaroori hai. It's very, very important. And how do we do that? Now, this passion can be of n number of kinds. It can be that of wealth, it can be that of affluence, it can also be that of social service. I would definitely prefer the second one. That try to have this one ideal, you know, this is one passion that you can clearly take up. You don't need any classes for that. That is, try whatever you want. Keep this thing in mind that whatever you want to do in future, I want to have a positive impact in somebody's life. I want to have a positive role in society. I want to do something good. Now, whatever be the means, whatever be the way, I will do that. Just keep this goal at the back of your mind. And this will show a lot of light to you. We live in a country, you know, where on one side we are expecting that we'll become a $5 trillion economy in a decade or so. But at the same time, we have almost around 38% of our children who are malnourished. At the same time, almost 52% of our women in our country, they are anemic. Do you know what is the IMR, infant mortality rate in Madhya Pradesh? Or in the states nearby, in UP, in Bihar, in Rajasthan? In our country, there are a lot of statistics, you know. There's one organization called the National Crime Records Bureau, NCRB. It says that in our country, there's one dowry death every 4 minutes. I am posted in a place, I am posted in a district where the incidence of child marriage is highest in the country. I did myself witness two deaths where a girl has committed suicide, thrown herself into the well because her parents had already done her marriage when she was a child and were now forcing her to go to that home, that house, which she did not want to. We are all sitting here in wonderful chairs discussing and being comfortable in AC and air condition. And trust me, and you, I know most of you know this, if you just take any road from this place, move 90 kilometers into the rural part of the country, look at a school, and then you will find there are children who are just sitting on bare ground. You'll find that for five classes in a primary school, we only have two teachers. In our country, we lack 12 lakh teachers. हमारे देश में 12 लाख टीचर्स की कमी है. हमारे देश में 12 मिलियन बच्चे अभी भी चाइल्ड लेबर में इंक्लूड हैं. That's the country we live in. So that is the reality that we are facing. And this reality, I think it's something that should motivate us, that should ignite that fire in our hearts. That whatever I do, it doesn't matter, you know, becoming a civil servant, becoming an IAS officer is not it. Kitne banenge? It's not everything. You know, as they say, you don't need Archimedes' lever to change the world. But good intention, good effort, that sensitivity, that compassion inside your heart, those small acts of kindness jahan pe bhi aap kuch acha kar paaye, try to do that. With whether you teach somebody, whether you feed somebody, whether you help somebody, I think that's enough. I think that can make this world such a better and even wonderful place to be. So, I will sort of try to lighten up the air. Try to keep this thing in mind, that whatever you do, and it doesn't mean a person will fail twice, 100 times, doesn't matter. But just try to keep this one thing in your mind, that you will always try to strive for doing that good, strive for doing that little bit. I'm sure we will live in a better and a wonderful place. Thank you so much, and God bless you. Have a wonderful career. And I'm sure you will all make us proud in whichever way and whichever field you will land. Thank you so much.